to sound check somebody.
Testing, testing. Oh, that's loud.
Working perfectly. Thank you very much. And it appears my sound is also working. So let me check the date. It seems to be Tuesday, May 17th, 2016. Therefore, it is the Keshe Plasma Reactor Night. And I'm Rick Crammond, your host, as usual, for the last few years. And it has been years. And tonight, as is our habit for the last few times, we're going to start with Lee Coates' video. And here, let me spotlight that. And second screen, there we go. So, as usual, we're very curious to what you're up to here. It looks like you've magnified and multiplied your family there over the last week or so.
Yeah, my one little spinning ball was so easy to make that I've decided to put it in a starship formation since I had all the motors and parts and stuff sitting around. So I got six little spinning balls now in that formation. I decided to put the ones on top there spinning sideways is probably not the right way to do it, but it was easy to do that way, so I did it. But yeah. Yeah, I got one spin and say clockwise, the other one's spinning counterclockwise, and then spinning clockwise again, just so that I figured the fields sort of would weave in and out with each other or something. I don't know. But it's spinning. That's correct. Just like gears, basically. That was my theory, anyway. But anyway, on the bottom ones, I got a lead gants and CH3 gants. They got different proportions on the bottom. One's 50-50, one's about 30% lead. The other one's about 25% lead. The ones on top, I got brass in the lower one. And then I got CH3. I think I got a couple of drops of lead in that. And then I just put hydrogen in the top one. So, but haven't noticed any effects coming off of it. So, but yeah. So, well, when I first set them up, I set them up at 2,500. Right now, they're just spinning randomly here. I haven't readjusted them for RPMs. Now, that I didn't have enough motor controllers, so these top three are running off the same motor controllers. So I think I got about, I had 2,500 there, and I had about 1,500 there, and I had 4,000 there, just the way they worked. So, yeah, they're wired in series. Yeah, or different resistances in the motors or something, I don't know. So anyway, it was a simple build, and I said, why not? Let's go for it. So I don't know why. Yeah, so some I found on eBay. I think they ship out of Hong Kong or something. Yeah, we got the variable speed knob and the on-off reverse switch. So, I think they go up to 24 volts, these ones.
Sorry, the live stream was not, audio was not on. I'm talking to... We're hearing one side of the story there, but Anyway, they were missing the questions that I was asking. I was just asking what the controller was, and he was and what voltage and so on. The motors will go up to 24 volts apparently. So, all right, cool.
So anyway, now I got a new different Starship formation.
Now you've got one running. I see something running in the lower right corner, isn't it?
This guy down here?
Yeah, yeah.
That was one from last week.
Oh yeah, that's the one that wants to run away.
It's gone out of balance on me. I gotta, I guess, replace the ball and try and get it balanced again. But I think I hit it and it knocked it off center.
Yeah, it's tricky to keep the balls all lined up good. Okay, well.
Lee, can I ask how much those controllers cost, each one?
They're about, I bought them about a year ago, and I think they're, they're less than $10 and maybe $5 or $6, I forget. They're in that range, from $5 to $10.
And a little micro part with the on-off switch and the turner all come as one part?
That's correct. All this comes as one unit.
Good. Thank you.
And you get them at eBay. At least that's where I got them last year. And I got these little motors at eBay too.
Are those Dymium motors?
I don't think so.
No, they look just like just standard hobby motors.
Yeah, they're real cheap. They're the cheapest motor you can get. They're nothing special.
Well, I went to the hobby store again because I went from a car motor or boat motors to car motors like that spin like 30,000 RPMs, and they're only like $22.
These came in a package of 10 for about, I don't know, $20 or something.
Nice.
And okay. Yeah, they're, I forget what, they might be 10,000 RPM or 8,000 RPM or something, motors, because right now I'm just barely cracking the voltage on them to get them running at 2,400, so they'll run.
The RC car and hobby motors for the radio-controlled vehicles are way too robust. It's serious overkill.
Will that controller that he has slow it down?
Yes.
That's what I'm hoping.
Like my power supply right now is at 8 volts, and I'm just barely cracking the variable resistor there to get it to about 2,000 RPM.
Yeah, with a pulse modulated controller like those, you've got a really wide range on your voltages. And a wide range on your speeds as well, because you're putting full voltage to the motor, but you're only putting it there for a very, very short sliver of time. Yeah, I've noticed some of my motors whistle at low speeds. You can hear the frequency.
Well, then, I checked on motors for these boats, these hydroplane boats, that these remote control boats, that they have the hydro, resistance of the water. And the guy said that, you know, because I was worried about that. And he said, if you get one of these motors, they're a little bit more balanced. They're more money, of course, but they're more balanced. And then it has the complete shaft that comes out that you can attach to.
Yeah, the model motors will work really good. They're just serious overkill, that's all.
Okay. So what Denny's got is more than enough.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. because you'll start to get a wobble in whatever you put on top of it.
Yeah, on a little more practical note, a ping pong ball full of water at 30,000 RPM is probably not going to stay together.
Hi Lee, this is Tony from Australia. I wanted to ask you how you're determining speed.
Yeah. I got a meter for measuring RPM, so I got a little reflective dot on there and the meter shoots a laser beam on it and bounces back and tells me how many RPM.
Yeah, that seems like the best way to go. Yeah, thanks. Great. Yeah.
Yep.
Definitely a toy I need in my toolbox. Yeah.
With all the tools.
I picked mine up for $28.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. Wow. This is at AliExpress. They've got them. I think they're $26 or $28.
Yeah.
I paid another $30 to get it within 3 days. So.
Yeah, that's what I was expecting. Yeah,
I think I paid over $100 at Amazon.
Everything you want is $100.
Yeah, and then you need to build a bigger lab.
What store did you get them on?
Are they hollow? Oh, yeah.
That is cool. Wow.
Yep.
What do you call those so we can search for them?
Yeah, what I noticed when I ordered my glass balls, they weren't very well made. They're really off center, and one side's heavier than the other. I think to get a decent glass ball, you're gonna have to spend the money.
Do you know the purpose for them, Rick? Why the ring? Yeah. Yeah. Wow. Yeah, hey, we can be wearing out the answers. Yeah, brilliant. That's brilliant. That emergency GANS kits, you know, you get, you know, 5 or 6 of them just hanging around, you know. Yeah, that's great giveaways for people. Yeah.
Yeah, we got Jackie in now too, Rick.
How big is it?
It looks about the same as a ping pong ball.
Ping pong, yeah.
Yeah, I've been using those. You can get, I got some inch and a quarter, which I've been putting inside my reactor coils, and you can get them all the way up to 4 or 6 inches, the whole range of size.
Yeah. Hey brother, whatever it takes.
Whirly.
Just make sure your glue's good or you'll end up painting yourself.
That's all right, too. It might be a silly question for me to ask, but, and I'm kind of still a novice in all of this, but for plastic. Oh,
sorry, my live stream was off again there. I'm not sure why that keeps doing that. Okay, go ahead. Sorry, didn't mean to interrupt. Say again.
No problem. Just a question about nano-coating plastic. Where are we as far as how, you know, what's the best way and what are we looking for to make sure that the plastic is completely nano-coated? So if you made that Gantz, you know, that ball that you have there, would you dip it in caustic to try to create the Gantz or the nano effect?
Yeah, it depends, and I've thought about that for ping pong balls as well, because dipping in GANS or dipping in caustic might be the end of the ping pong ball in a way. Because for example, if you try to create a full vacuum in a ping pong ball, it's a dicey thing. A slight dent will cause it to collapse. If you weaken the walls by putting caustic on it, it might collapse too easily in that circumstance. It could be fine for spinning at 1,000 RPM or something, but it still might make the surface soft. I think what most people do, or what's been recommended, is to use the cold caustic spray. Just do a light spray, let it sit for a while, rinse it off later, and you can test it by doing voltage readings on the surface. And resistance readings on the surface, so you can see if you should have at least kilo-ohms, if not mega-ohms, of resistance, right, John? Does that sound about right on the plastic?
Well, with the plastic, I don't know if the resistance is going to work because it's not a conductor to begin with. So you're going to be relying on if the coating itself is conductive. Not sure if that's quite how it works. Doesn't seem like that would be the way to go. Maybe there's a light system. You could bounce a laser off it. I don't know. I'd have to do some more research on it.
So really, plastics have ever been really, we don't really know exactly if nano coating is really taking to the plastics of any sort or not.
Well, I wouldn't say that. I would say that we don't have a way to measure the quality of the coating. So with the cold caustic method, just spray it, leave it for 3-4 days, and trust that it's coated, because it will be.
With those balls like Rick was showing, the split balls, I've been just soaking them in cold caustic for 24 hours, and no problem. Even ping pong balls, I'll fill them up in the inside with a syringe with cold caustic and leave them soaking in the bath overnight.
Okay, right on.
And that's had no problem. So,
okay.
I had an interesting experience nano coating plastic cups. A steam coat.
Mario, hi Mario.
You're in the bathroom, Mario.
Hey, Mario, let's all just congratulate you on your presentation. You did a wonderful, wonderful job with your presentation.
Yeah, I thought so too, so congratulations indeed.
It took a lot to come out to Mr. Keshe and say what you did and think what you had and stand in front of your creation and take it.
Yeah, it's true. Like, you never know what it's going to end up
with. You never know what you're going to get.
Yeah.
Well, what surprised me is he said, you are correct. Like, correct? I thought he was going to say, no, wait, you know. But anyway, I'm still not sure about it. There's another level of thing happening here. I'm not sure what's what. But
yeah.
Last, I nanocoated one cup, and then I got a larger container. I nanocoated it 5-6 times. The Chinese fella, nanocoated that plastic cup 30 times in a row. And then he was able to do the wire thing. So, and what I found when I was nanocoating this cup over and over and over again, I put a couple of other cups in there. So they had been nanocoated once or twice or whatever. But this cup had been nanocoated 10 times or whatever. I accidentally banged a container or something happened and the cups fell into the water, the boiling water. And the other cups melted, but the one that had been nanocoated a bunch of times didn't melt. And so I started nanocoating the cup right in the water and it wasn't melting. The others I had to steam. What I was trying to do, there was something else, I don't know where I got this idea, that adding electric current, but you can't run it. So what I did was I ran a DC current. I just put a piece of copper wire in the container and then just ran the current through the wire while the cups are steaming and while the one is blown. And after about 8 or 10 times or something nanocoating that cup, and at least once or twice with the electric current, the presence of the electrolysis, I got a wire to move in the cup. It only lasted about 45 minutes, and then it just faded. And I was like, wow, okay. So I guess the nanolayers were not, but I'm sure that there's only two ways I can think of to know whether the plastic is totally nanocoated. That would be, it won't melt. If you try that and it melts, then you got your back to square one again. The other would be it behaves in a way that allow the wire thing in some way or another. It's, you know what I mean? But it shouldn't melt if it's totally nanocoated.
Well, it does melt. And I tried it.
But I mean, if you nanocoat it 15, 20, 30 times, well, then you'll get clear, it won't melt. Because if it's totally nanocoated, it can't melt. Because that's impervious to heat. Doesn't,
right? Well, you got a point there, because what can happen, or what could happen, with the plastics having a large carbon content, you could be creating a diamond-like coating on the surface of the plastic. And that actually does help to dissipate heat and so on, like diamonds.
Well, what I had happen, and when I first tried to work with these vinyl tubes and plastic tubes, I can get from anywhere, quarter inch, half inch, you know, and the plastic caps and all that. So I kept thinking, how can I get the nano coating to go into the plastic? And I thought, well, cold caustic, and it didn't look like it changed the property at all. So then I thought, well, let's try just taking the crock pot, dipping it in the cold caustic, and then I made a little holder to put it in the crock pot and let it cook in the crock pot. Well, come to find out, the crock pot cooks it up way too hot, and the plastic melted. Because after 160 degrees or 170 degrees, it just loses form and shape.
They use caustic as a process to break down bottles, soda water bottles and so on, that are notoriously take a long time to break down in the landfills. So they actually use caustic as a means of degrading the plastic.
so I learned the hard way or the easy way.
Well, it depends on the concentration. That's what makes the heat and the heat, you know, temperature, as well as the pH, all those things.
All that, I think that all matters, because I really worked a lot with the vinyl tubing. So I went out, you know, I buy stuff at the thrift store, and I went with the, I love the thrift stores. They're the best.
Yeah.
So I got a crock pot the last time. I'm redoing everything, so I have to re-go out and do everything. I double-step everything I did now, but now it made me learn a little bit more. And I went and got a roaster oven.
Mm-hmm.
And with the roaster oven, now it'll allow me to hold the temperature from 120 to 500 degrees with water or caustic water that I'm gonna it seemed to me that when you put it in the crock pot and heated it, but it wasn't quite hot enough because the ceramic pot didn't give it enough heat.
It's so not now, meant to boil really, it's just meant to simmer at a hot temperature. Right.
Mm-hmm. So I took it up another level.
Exactly.
But I did start to see a change in the plastic tubing itself after I did it maybe 3 or 4 or 5 times. I did it 12. Everything I did 12 times. But did the caustic in the crock pot 12 times in the caustic. And it finally turned the tubing like a whitish gray.
Right. That's what I was going to suggest, is you get a whitish sort of translucent coating that can happen.
Then I actually thought, well, maybe some of these properties are actually starting to change. So then I thought, well, 12 times, and then, but I thought, always kept thinking that, and I used my temperature reading in my caustic solution, and it would only get up to like 100 and maybe 130. It was in the garage and it was in the winter time, so the crock pot would never get any hotter than maybe at its highest point, like I said, maybe 120, 130 degrees.
Right. I have a crock pot out in my deck here, and it's the same situation. On cold nights, it doesn't get hot enough.
It just doesn't get. So that's why I bought the roasting pan. And we're going to see what happens.
I almost bought a deep fryer the other day, and I look at all the new appliances coming out with lust in my eyes.
I went to the one thrift store, and it was like $25, and I thought, I don't want to spend $25. I went to another one, and it was like $12.50.
Well, that, I was just going to say the words $12.50. That's what I paid at the Walmart for my heating, or my ceramic, crock pot. So they had them on sale, and they have them fairly cheap there, so it's actually not a bad deal. Sometimes Salvation Army.
Cheap. I just enjoy a good deal.
Yeah, sometimes the Salvation Army can be more expensive than what you get for on sale at Walmart. And strangely enough,
they make money too. They're happy. The lady goes, oh, you're taking all this stuff up. It's been sitting on the shelf for 2 weeks now. I said, well, it's going to serve me, my purpose, well, and it might help a lot of other people.
Yeah, she said, yeah. Yeah, they love me too, because I get rid of old inventory. things people have no imagination to use, and somehow I managed to drag it home.
And then when I was there, I bought a big motor and that big hub, and I don't know what I'm going to do with it. You buy stuff, you see, so you walk up to the shelf, and it was like...
It's bad. It's bad. That's why you need to have an expanding lab, you know, and that's why I kicked myself out of my bedroom, is I need more shelf space. Maybe I should start a store. Should start a dollar store.
This part of the room of my house. Yeah,
I have to continually do cleanup. That's the problem with those kind of crazy projects and so on. And that's the big advantage of the newer techniques of just using your mind and emotions and so on to create the reactor space. You don't have to go to the Salvation Army to pick up parts necessarily. You can find them inside your own self. So that's a big advantage, especially for those in space who may not have that Salvation Army around the corner to drop in to pick up parts.
Well, I realize though that we're lucky enough to be here right now, and this is what we have, and this is what we need. So you might as well get in there, get it, and get what you, you know, to do what we have to do.
Sure, we can try all realms is what I figure, and the idea is sort of to try everything and not get stuck in a way. Because Kesh talks about, you know, the different levels that people can exist on Earth and so on. And you can be stuck on the physicality level, or you can get stuck on the nanomaterial level. You can get stuck on the GANS level. You can get stuck even on the plasma level. But the ultimate is to become the plasma manipulator, so you're able to work through all dimensions and see it all as plasma anyway, and manipulate it to the advantage of those around you at that point, more than to your own advantage. And in that way, you know, that's like one of the highest realms to work from, let's say, as a true creator.
It works both ways. You're creating, and it works with your emotions. That's the whole thing. If you can't get those two working together, you're going to have a problem. One way, you know, one will work one way, but one won't work the other way. And it's no harmony there. And I experienced that firsthand. And that's what scared me the most, because I wasn't in touch with my emotions. You know, I was just oh, this is all scary, voodoo stuff, you know what I'm saying? But it forced me, if you want to continue on doing the things you're doing, it actually makes you think about things that you never thought about before,
mm-hmm.
whether you want to or not.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're a thinker, and if you want to use your mind, and you want to go and research more things about what we're trying to do, it's been around for a long, long time, longer than we could even think about. But people left markers and hints and ideas for us to try to pick up on as humans or humanity. We've just been so dumbfounded with American Idol and Boo Boo and Doo Doo. And, you know, we're so they want us, not even they, it's just the populace doesn't want to really do anything. So,
well, the way I look at it, I came to the conclusion many years ago after sort of investigating that idea that there seems to be two streams in the planet. Those that are here just for fun and those that are here for learning. And those were the two main streams. It didn't mean that learning was serious, but, you know, the saying is if you're doing it right. If you're not having fun, then you're not doing it right as far as the learning part. But still, there's people that are more fun oriented. They're here on the planet to have fun, and it's, you know, indulge in all the things that they consider to be fun. And others are here to be serious learners, you might say, and they go through fun experiences, but they also go through traumatic experiences just to be able to experience those things and to learn from them and so on. Like you had to go through your emotional trauma in order to learn from that, and that's made you stronger, obviously, and you came right back, and like someone kicked off a horse and you get right back on and away you go kind of thing, you know. So this is part of what we learn, I think, especially if you're working toward being a plasma manipulator, then you get yourself in situations and you get yourself out of them so you can get to the next level. And sometimes you might fall down a couple levels and have to build back up again and so on. But that's part of the fun of the game to me, in a way. Other people might want to just have fun and they're not interested in evolving or necessarily going to a higher level. But I think there's more pressure on the planet now to do that. It's time to evolve, and we're all evolving all at once. Even the dogs and cats and dolphins and everybody else seems to get dragged along as we go to this next level. So
I think they're getting it faster than we are.
I think so too. I'm starting to think, wow, I saw some seals playing volleyball, and they had three of them on each team, and they were spiking the ball and setting it up and back and forth, and they had way more control than I did playing in, you know, varsity in high school or whatever. And I just went, wow, look at that. I can't believe this one hit it right down. The other one would grab it. I mean, not grab it, but hit it. Be able to balance it on his nose and slam it back. And so I just, whoa, this is incredible. They had two referees that were refereeing the game for them. And, you know, and you see all kinds of things like that on Facebook these days. Facebook is dangerous that way.
What did one dolphin say to the other dolphin? Look at them out there.
Yeah, look at those guys watching us. Huh. Yeah,
well,
so
I don't want to take any more of your time. If I come up with any more ideas, I'll pop back in.
Great, Alan. Thank you.
Thanks,
Ken. Okay. Who else we got for what here at this point? Any questions or things to present or otherwise?
Comments? Well, before we come on air, we had some questions about the nutrition system, and we asked Jackie come in. Maybe we can get him to talk a little bit about that.
Thank you for that reminder. Hi, Jackie. How are you doing today?
Hi, Rick. Hi, very, very good. And you?
Good, good.
Can I help you?
Well, first of all, I was going to put up this, let me put up the banner that you had here. Maybe you can explain about that a bit. And we had a question from someone, so let's get that screen shared. And can you tell us all, what's this all about now? This seems to be something happening on, I know, Jeudi is Thursday. So
yep.
Tell us.
So we manage with the education part to start giving the teaching in French for the French speaking guys. And so we have the every Thursday at 7 Central European time, a public teaching. We set up Thursday because it's we can have a small recap of the teaching in the different workshop from Mr. Cash, and then we allow the public to show what they are doing in the French speaking part, and then we set up the teachings for the education site in French. So since we will have some students for the French speaking, we will start the private teaching for the French people, so they can register on the education site. And then we will have some days the teaching in French, like they are doing with the Italian people. And I know the German people will start soon.
Great. So they register on the education site, and do they have to pay like the $100 fee to be a student and so on, or is it just they just register on the site?
Yeah, for the public it's free. It's like the public workshop that Mr. Cash give. And for the education site, yes, it's the 100 euros per year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, good. And what will be some of the topics? So you'll be covering the things that were in the workshop, I guess, the Knowledge Seekers workshop that would be previous in the day. Are you also giving people feedings and that kind of thing from your unit, or you get involved with that with this workshop?
Yeah, we start to giving the feedback of the workshop. Then we have a small teaching part on different subjects. like feeding, but we are the beginning in the French speaking, so we start with basic things like making GANs, and then we have some sharing time, and then we have some question and answers time.
Excellent, I see. Okay, well, we had a question. Who was that question from about whether they could join in with Jackie's group to get the feeding? John, did you know about that?
I thought it was Doug. He had to go to work.
Okay.
That he'd listen to the recordings afterwards.
Right.
I think the question was he had a lady there who's having a really hard time absorbing nutrition, and if there's a way that she can access the nutrition reactor remotely.
Yeah. So if I can give some advice, because I have some experience with the feeding system with different person, with the students of the education site and the spaceship group and different person in my private family, and only with the system it's some problem for different people to cover the different things they need. And I make some research on these fields, and I have some different experience, so I can share some of this. But if I just can share my screen. The important things when we start with the feeding system is understanding of what the body is made. And if we take a look, it's oxygen, it's 65, carbon 18.5, hydrogen 9.5, nitrogen 3.2, and then we have some calcium, phosphor, and then the rest is really less. So if we can make the CHON, the Mr. Cohen, we have 65, 75, 83.5, 96.2 of the percentage in the body, it's only the CoHN. So with the system, with the coils, with the all the element, we have all the CoHN. So if you want in the for the physicality with the feeding system, when you start understanding, you have not so much problem to feed with and interact with the system and take all the elements you need. But what I can see, the most difficult problem, it's not the physical body, it's not the energy part, it's the mind who needs some help to understand. So what we are doing right now to make more easy for the people, it's something like that. I want to show you one second. I can't play with that. Where is my Zoom meeting? I don't have access to my, okay.
You may have to stop your share to get to it.
Exactly. Okay, so I will show you how I'm making my my feeding right now. You will see it's really easy. Because I'm more feeding my mind than my my physicality. So I just take, this is a normal natural water, but you can take what water you like distilled water, like energy water, like you want. And I put this water. Then I have an agreement with my mind. You know, I have my three different Ganses. If you take a look, you have the CH3, you have the CuO, and you have the CO2. And like Mr. Cash, you have the nitrogen into it. And so you have 96.2. And you have the copper, you have the zinc oxide, you have the iron oxide, and you have different other combinations. So it's a lot. And this is how I proceed. For example, with the CO2, it's my base. It's every time I take the CO2. So for example, I take 10 from the CO2 because I want to cover all my emotion part. Then it's the beginning of the day, so I want some energy. So what is energizing? It's the it's the CH3. So I take full of CH3. And then I just want some, I don't want not so much draining, so I take just a little bit of the CuO. And I have my mixture for right now. And now...
Jackie, wouldn't that be a little bit of cross-contamination between the three?
Sorry, I just take a few drops. I don't understand really your question.
When you put your syringe in the three different solutions, yeah. Don't you touch the tip to each one so each one would be one and the same?
Yeah, it can be. You know, but this is, for example, this is my understanding. It's I only deal with the liquid plasma, and it's what Mr. Cash said. You doesn't need to make so much calculation and so much because you deal only with the liquid. And this process, it's more for my mind. It's more an agreement for my mind that I decided what I want, because when I make the process to make my mixture, I make the giving part, if you want, because I put my intention and I give when I decided what I want, and I give some energy, for example, with the CH3, and I give the draining part with the CO, and I give the emotional part, and I make the interaction. And yeah, but you are right. Normally you can have three different syringes, or you can wash every time you make it. At the beginning, I was doing that. And after 2 months, I'm not so involved with that. And this is my... this okay, is my
thank you.
You're welcome. And this is my habit. I take the important things. It's to respect your habits of the feeding, you know, because here I just wake up. I was sleeping and I have the information for the meeting, so I wake up. And so this is my petit déjeuner, my breakfast. And then I have the dinner time. And during the day, sometimes I feel some need from food. So I make the same, and I can make different setups. So it's why I don't making a lot of liquid. And this is so much for the day. You know, I only take few drops, and then I can take if I need a little bit more, I take it. And I try with different other person, for example, with my girlfriend, and she never been involved with the plasma because she doesn't live with me. She live in another country. And the last time I will visit her, I take all my liquid plasma and we make the same process. And from the morning until the night, we eat nothing. She just eats some seeds or some, just to have something to chew. And on the evening, we want to have a social communication and some pleasure. And so at the evening, we take a lunch that we really enjoy. And that's it for all the day. And we make 10 days like this, and she have no problem. She make a school for actress, and they make a lot of physical activity like gym and singing and dancing and all these kind of things. And she doesn't eat for the day, and she have no problem with energy, and she's totally good. And the other person who tried this have the same result. And with this setup, it's really more easy than just only interacting with the system. Because for your mind and for your body, if you have something physical, it's because you have the part of the liquid, you continue to have a little connection with the physicality. And this is really, really more easy at the beginning. And then you can start playing with the different food games and try different setup, and you can make exactly the same. You, for example, you make a mix from the vegetables, and then you only take a few drops and you add to the liquid. And for the moment, I just thinking regarding the food gains, because for the moment I make it with the NaOH, and to take the liquid, it's not so good. We need to really good wash, and it's not so easy. It takes time. And so perhaps with only putting some aliments in the CO2 kit and mixing, and I don't know if what the results we have. So I'm starting learning and researching on the different ganses of food, vegetables, fruits, different vitamins in supplements like B6, B12, B2, and all the vitamin, and some like protein. I make some gains of protein. We can try the same with the the minerals, gains of minerals. And for the moment, for the feeding system, it's the game, but all the time it's the same. We need to understand the Maghreb feeding system. It's why it's Mr. Keshe, one we speak about the Maghreb feeding system, because we need to understand the giving and taking part. And when you start feeding in this way, you just realize you really need your body, you really need a few to be in a very good shape. And then you have so much energy, and you have a totally different energy, because now you are feeding yourself with a life energy, with a total pure energy, and you doesn't take energy from dead animals or dead vegetables or fruits. You start really dealing with the interaction of the fields, and you are not taking the life of another entities. You are just dealing with the fields. And my three parts, my plasma state, my emotional state, and my physical state, have different fields, and I try to satisfy with interacting with other fields. And I can give my field to the others, and they can take what I doesn't need, and I can take what they want to give me. And this is the true learning. And this is beautiful, because when you understand the life in the deeper space, and you understand that perhaps you will have no body and perhaps you will have different bodies. And when we need to start understanding that we need to feed in another way that we have learned into planet Earth, because it will be a big problem in deeper space to feed with carrot and avocado and the meat and all these kind of things. So for my understanding, it's an important learning, the feeding system. Not feeding with killing, but feeding with giving energy and taking energy from the fields of the different interaction, and this is the game. And for myself, it is more than 2 months I'm dealing with that. And I have only a few meal every 2 or 3 days in the evening. In the evening, it's a little bit more difficult. I don't know why, but in the evening, it's more difficult for me. All the day, I have no problem. But in the evening, it's a little bit more difficult. And the last thing it's important to know, it's when you start trying to fly and trying to be the pilot, for the moment, my understanding, it's like if we learn to manage the fly, you know, because it's only with the mass. The more the mass you have, the more you are attracted into planet Earth and you stay connected with the physical state. And the less you eat and the less you take, the more lift you can start accessing. And if when you eat, you get the physical connection, and when you doesn't eat, you start elevating really more. And for the moment, we are starting to adjust the fly and take some flying. And after some few, you say, oh, it's not the moment. I need to take some liquid or I need to take some food because I'm going too fast and I want to really a little bit slow down the process until we are ready for the big fly. But the important things, it's what I understand, it's not important. It's really important to be the pilot and understanding how to fly, but it's a lot of brother and sister into planet Earth, and it will be not so good to fly alone. And we have a big responsibility for the knowledge and for the sharing of the knowledge to, if we can reach a lot and the maximum of people to help to join the fly, it will be really nice. And so my goal and my wish, it's like Mr. Keshe said yesterday, we doesn't need anyone dying for starvation of food and have some food problems. And I'm sure if we take a look on the liquid plasma, on the food GANs, we found the right way and we found the right combination with the amino acid too. We need to discover more into the amino acid and found the process with really easy and simple. For example, if you give one bottle of this to the person for the homeless of your town and they feed themselves for the weeks, I think it will be the most beautiful things we can make, you know? And after that will be the fact to keep out the liquid plasma, only to interact with the fields. So with the cube that Mr. Keshe presented yesterday, it will be really easy to have something, and then a lot of different container with all the different GANs, and you will have the interaction. And then we need to learn how to tap just into it to feed our three parts. And this is my experience. This is where I am right now. You're welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much. Does anybody have any questions for Jackie or anything that they'd like to clarify? Let me have a look at the live stream here too. I have to
get that. Yeah, this is Tony in Australia. I just want to say that, you know, it's people like Jackie and Rick and all you guys that, you know, really inspire people, particularly myself. You know, we're talking earlier about being when you get stuck, and it's meetings like this that inspire me, that move me along or get me thinking in a different direction. And I just wanted to say I appreciate that so much from you guys and everyone that participates.
Hi, Rick. Hi, Jackie. Mother's here. I have a question. Did someone try to take the water from the amino acid, the same like when it goes in the bottom, and to add the water of the amino acid from the CO2 when you washed out, and like when you was doing these bottles with CH3, CO2, and the copper oxide? I tried to also to do the same thing. Just to add also a bit of water from the Kochen. I cannot say like it's fully satisfied my appetite, but energy wise I can feel it's giving. So of course there is another energy involved because there is CO2 and rest. Just my question is, did you try something like that? And what is your thoughts about that? I can't hear you somehow. I think your mic is off.
Yeah, excuse me. I have some problem with the amino acid. I need to figure out how to wash it clean and how to interact with. But the amino acid is the COHN and we have a lot with the three different Ganses. And for me, what we need to understand, it's not so much the what we put into it, it's giving and bringing understanding to our mind how the body works and how the body converts the food into energy. And it's why I start researching on the digestive system, because Mr. Cash said we will lose after 6 months, we will lose our digestive system because we doesn't need anymore. So I make some different research on the digestive system. And when you start understanding how the body converts the physical food into energy, and you start understanding, you can, when you take the liquid plasma, you make exactly the same that your body make when it converts the food into energy. And when your mind start understanding, this is exactly the same energy, and it doesn't need to take physical food. Here you can to starting satisfy your appetite, because it's the mind who is saying that you need to eat. And when you start understanding the process, at the beginning it's 2 or 3 days, like for example, if you try to stop smoking or different addiction, the first at the beginning it's a little bit difficult, you know, because it's not the starvation from the body, it's the starvation for the mind, because it's the emotional state who feel not good, he feel not satisfied, and he need to take something. And he said, hey guys, I'm still alive, you need to take care of me and I need all your attention. And at one time, you need to, if you want to go much deeper in the process and you have the intention to go in the feeding, in the space feeding system Magrav, you need to say to your body, look, I know what I'm doing. I doesn't want to hurt you. I will take care of you. I know what I'm doing, so shut up and let's say and play this game. You know, you need to be the commander. You need to be the pilot. You are in control and you manage the things, and it's not your mind or your physical parts who dictate the game. But at one time, you need to be the commander. You need to be the pilot and start shutting up your command and programmation that are saying, I need to eat. I need to eat. I will die, you know? And after one day, 2 days, 3 days, you become more comfortable. And the last thing is you need to be ready and you need to enjoy the process and you need to, yeah, because it's not a starvation. It's a really good, nice energy. And for me, for myself, it's the most important thing. It's to have fun and to enjoy the process. And at the beginning, looking at the different parts, the emotion and the physical problems, it's so nice to see. But I need to be honest with you, the 2 or 3 first day, it's not so easy. But, you know, it's only 2 or 3 days for the eternity, so it's quite nothing.
That's a good way to put it. Sacrifice 2 or 3 days for eternity in exchange.
Yeah.
Anybody want to make that swap? We have a trainer here that can help you.
I just want to say thank you, Jackie. And about the washing, I just fill up the full bottle with the water where was the amino acid, and it's sort of goes gradually down in the bottom, and so basically you can drain the top water, which is salty, and put another one, and you wash almost the same like you wash the normal Gans.
Okay, perfect, thank you very much.
No worries.
Can I ask a question? Right now, Jackie, you're just using those 3 Gans waters? But you're also adding, yes, 3 waters to it.
No, for the moment, I only use these 3 Gans.
Are you trying to keep the balance of the... You're trying to figure out to get the balance that's equal to the charge you throw on the body?
It's a nice... What you said is really nice. No, I don't keep the same, but it's a really good idea. You really need to take some agreements with your mind and make something that you feed with your emotion, you know? And if you can adjust with the need of the body, like the percentage we see before, like you have the ID, it will be a really nice agreement with your mind, you know, because it will fit with yourself ideas. And you it's know, a beautiful idea.
Did you smoke before? I smoke cigarettes. I'm more worried about I can't quit smoking than I can't quit eating.
Yeah. You know, I'm so, no, for the moment, I'm smoking. And what I'm doing, I'm putting some liquid CO2 plasma into it.
Oh, it works? Helps?
Yeah, it helps because I'm reduced for the half, because I make half normal liquid and half CO2 liquid. So I consume half of what I'm consuming before. And it's not so, you know, I start to don't have the same pleasure to smoke, and I start going down with the smoking.
But you still, okay, yeah.
Yeah. I manage the fly, you know, we need to.
Yeah. Hi, Jackie, I need to apologize. This is Mark from Detroit.
Hi, Mark.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Pleased to meet you. I didn't mean anything about the cross-contamination, about all that. Who cares about that? What I really care about is that you're really making GANS materials. And because that's where I'm starting. I think that's where it's all, where we start is how we make it. You know, with the salt water, we start with the salt water, wherever it comes from. And I know you're starting to break down different products in the salt water with the caustic. Is that how you're doing it with small amounts of caustic? Say you introduce whatever you introduce into the mixture, it's salt, whatever you introduce in caustic, and then you rinse it so that you make GANS out of that. Is that how I'm?
Yeah, it's this I learned from Carolina. It was 3 or 4 months. She said we need to mix, have a good mix of the elements. So, for example, tomato, like you want, it's exactly the same with the seawater. And then we put some little bit of caustic soda. We put some boiling water or not, it's like you want. And then we let start the process, and after we make exactly the same washing of the like we make with the standard GANS, we throw away the liquid and put again some distilled water. But for myself, what I'm doing when I wash with the liquid plasma of the CO2, and I add some liquid plasma of CO2. And when you do that, you can see your GANS of foods becomes totally different, more like your normal GANS. Because at the beginning with the caustic soda, it's a little bit, it's not so like disorganization, you know, like if it's total mess. And when you put the liquid plasma of CO2, it's become more organized, that if every particle takes the right place.
So you rinse with your CO2.
Exactly.
So for instance, yeah. So I want the essence of apple.
Yeah.
I want apple, just for instance. So I have a little jar of salt water, you know, the salt water that I've made.
You don't need to take the salt water. You can only take the mixture of the apple. Only that.
Oh.
And then you, for example, if you have a mixer, you cut your apple and you mix your apple. Mm-hmm. So you have small particles because it's the first part. It's why we are chewing to reduce. Yeah. And when you have this mixture, you put some caustic soda into it. And then you put the boiling water into the container.
Okay.
Close the container and you keep it for 24 hours or 6 hours or 12 or like you want, like you understand it's okay for you. And then you start your washing, and my washing, it's half distilled water and half CO2 liquid plasma.
Okay.
Until I feel satisfied with the mixture. I can show you one I have.
Avocado mix.
This is one of the beautiful I have. It's from magnesium. Oh. It's a supplement of magnesium. And you know, it's become like a normal GANS, similar to CO2 GANS.
So you did that same process with magnesium?
Yeah. I make with tryptophan, 5-HTP, different. Yeah, you can, it's no limits to your imagination. But if I want to be really honest with you, I think all these different GANSes I think we doesn't want to play a lot with this. It's more to understanding the process on what's happening in our body and the combustion system of the body, and understand, because when you start making 20 or 30 different Ganses with the same process, and you see that every element, it's totally different. You know, I will to show, so you have a good example. With the same process, this is magnesium and this is protein.
What is that?
Protein. Oh, chocolate, so protein.
With made from a chocolate plant?
No, you know, you can buy in the market the supplements of protein, like the bodybuilder take.
Right.
And I make this with this. With this.
Oh, protein.
Yeah, protein. Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
But you know,
it's like a beautiful purple.
Yeah. And but you can see it in your body, it's approximately the same happening, and you start seeing that there is different fields, and you can have a good idea if you take that in your body, it's not the same results. And then, for example, this is ginger. And so ginger is totally different.
It almost looks like ginger on the bottom.
Yeah, it's like ginger, yeah. And this is this is carrot.
So now the top of each one of yours, you're going to put that on in your star formation so that you can taste or use that as a feeding energy in your body. Is that the process that we're trying to lead towards? You know, the Gans water in whatever form it comes.
Yeah, exactly. And but you know,
elements from everything. If we wanted a garden, we'd have to have broccoli. If we wanted a pine tree, we'd have to have pine cones. If we wanted orchids, we'd have to have the Gans of orchids.
Exact. And you know, for the mind, I'm sure this is a game mind, because if you take CO2, CH3, CO, you have the 96%, but for your mind to understand that you are feeding yourself with this, it's not so easy. When you start thinking, I'm feeding with carrots, I'm feeding with different vegetables, I'm feeding with, for example, meat, it's really more easy to understand for the mind. Oh, okay, it's no problem. I have what I need. But at the end, I'm sure we doesn't need any of these Gans, but it's fun. It's I enjoy the process. At the beginning of my life, I was a cook, you know, and I like playing with the elements, and it's fun. It's nice to see the different reaction, and it's so nice to see. And I start playing now with that, you know, it's... I start playing with the pH scale, because liquid caustic soda, it's 14. And when you start regarding what is doing your digestive system, you say it's the acid hydrochloric secreted from the stomach lining. And so right now, I'm starting to make some Gans with the hydrochloric acid, and you have totally new. I want to show you. I showed yesterday, but it's nice to see.
Yeah, yes.
Um,
I think this is going to work for me better if I can make Gantz of Mexican beer to start off with. Corona.
This is a Gantz with NaOH and acid hydrochloric. And it's beautiful because now you have the full spectrum in the acid and the basic, and you have the total separation. You know, you have really the gap between. It's not like this with only two separation. Here you have the three parts, you know, and you really have the gap between the two. And for the mind, it's so beautiful to see.
What is that on the top part?
It's more solid. It's like if you make it only with caustic soda, it's like if I take in, it's exactly the reverse process. This will be at the bottom and this at the top. And when you mix NaOH and hydrochloric acid, it's become totally different. You know, this goes up. You have the gap in the middle, and down it's something really different.
Is the hydrochloric acid in the middle? Do you think it's in the middle?
I don't know. The acid chloric make a reaction with the acid, with the caustic soda and the elements totally different. So I can't say today what I have because I'm not a chemist. I understand nothing, you know.
You know what you have? You have the French flag.
Yeah.
You created the French flag right in a jar.
Yeah.
Hello, Jakey.
Yeah.
This is Joe from Austria. We're talking about last time. Yeah.
Yeah.
If you get your GANs to produce your GANs, did you use electrical power or not? We have a big confusion in the Austrian group. They said that if you use electrical power, you have every time left-winded energy in the system, in every GANs. Don't use electrical power. Did you use for your GANs for the producing process some GANs electrical power or not?
I try, you know, me, I'm not a theoretical guy because I know nothing from chemistry and electricity and all these kind of things. So I like to play and make some experimentation. So I try all the different setup. I try with current, without current. And my understanding at this point, it's we need to try to fit the most with the natural process. And right now I'm not doing GANs with electric current. I let the nature do the process. Mm-hmm. And when you start dealing with the liquid plasma, it's become so nice because with this bottle is my CO2, and this is 2 months I play. You know, I only take the liquid and then I put water back. So this is my bottle for my life. So I doesn't need any more CO2 GANs. And when you have your three basic GANs, it's done for the eternity, you know. So 1 week to make a beautiful GANs without any load, it's not a problem, you know, because you doesn't need a lot. And for answering your question, I just want to show you a picture because for myself, if we are good in this process, it can be our gift for humanity. It will be so nice if every house in the... It's really basics. Just a second, you need to load because I have so much picture. I want to share the screen. So,
Jakey, I think you're the new Jacques Cousteau. You know, you're on a journey. like he was.
Yeah.
And I love the accent.
You know, this is the, for myself, what my understanding is, the Holy Grail that Mr. Keshe is giving to humanity. This is a small box. This is 24 small containers. I want to go in that side. So, for example, here you can make a four setup for your CO2 kit. You have 24 boxes, okay? So this is your CO2 setup with nano-coated copper and zinc. Here, for example, you can have your CH3 setup.
We have the same system. I know where I can get without power supplies. Yeah, we have the setup. Yeah. We have two parts. Yeah. We produce one time with electrical power, and we use and we have the same setup for we have a little bit bigger boxes. Yeah, but we have the same setup.
Yeah. And for example, here you can have your last basic setup with CuO, and then it's only 12. So you have 12 other box where you can have, for example, potatoes, tomatoes, avocado, B1, amino acid, protein, whatever you want. So if the people have this in this house, they have all the basic GANs. They have the basic production of energy. It's 17 volts. With this setup, you can see here, it's the light with no problem. It's a 6-volt LED without either running for 3 weeks without any problem. After five days, yeah.
Before you go further, I made similar system with just 10 of those cells, and it gives nice voltage. But next to it, I have my Fed Boy running, and then I also try to make the tube in a tube, you know, in this the last type of structure with the coils has been made. And I see, like, when these reactors run, it gives light, and like I switched off during the night, and light is gone somehow. It's interactive, and I think that this voltage what you have, I think it's also is being influenced by the another systems which is around.
Possible, I don't know.
This is just what I observed, because it's strange. Each time when I switched off, I see the voltage goes down.
Yeah, exactly. And then you have another beautiful thing, and it's you making your depollution, because you are taking the carbon from the outside. And then you have your swimming pool setup. Then you have your feeding system. Then you have your decontamination system. Then you have your shielding protection. And then you have your cleaning for the skin. You have all in this box. And if we can set up to manage a beautiful setup for the people and start giving this or selling this, I don't know if we, but it will be a so nice gift for humanity, you know, because, for example, you give this box to a homeless person, it's gone. He can feed himself, he can depollute, he can depollute the river, he can have all. But it's like Mr. Keshe said yesterday, we need to try to keep the most simple we can. And this is the most difficult part, you know, because as human, we love so much when it's complicated, and yeah, we need to learn to keep it really simple.
Yeah, it's a real engineering thing. The most beautiful things are the simplest, absolutely the most basic you can make a concept. You know, often it's the best way.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, this is my experimentation.
Yeah, it really resonates when you talked about taking the time to make the CO2. You know, because I used to use power a lot for it, and then I, you know, why am I using power? I'm using power because I want it now. I want it quick.
And yeah,
I think, but to get the right intention, you know, take the time. You know,
yes.
Let it cook. Yeah. Thanks, Jackie.
You're welcome. And you know, it's like the 3 days for the starting of the process. It's, we are speaking about eternity. So 5 days or 1 week to have a beautiful GANs with right intention. And these GANs will be the GANs for the next generation and the next generation. So 1 week for eternity.
Yeah, on our spaceships, we're going to need shelving to put our GANs. Well, actually, no, maybe we won't need them by then.
Yeah, because it's a great discussion we have with a lot of people. It's they said, yeah, but we doesn't need anything. We can have. Yeah, I said that's right, but it's right only when you are in the free plasma and you start dealing and tapping into the free plasma, because when you are in that state, that's right, that the physical universe and the matter doesn't count. But when you are into depths, when you are into health situation, when you are into work's problem, you deal with the problem with your wife and all these kind of things, you can decide it whatever you want, but nothing will work, you know. And this is only the tools to clean up your emotion, to clean up your body, to clean up all the mess that you accumulate from long time. And then when you start clean up, you start the process to clean yourself, to clean your mind. And then when you start reaching the point that you can tap into the free plasma, here's the life become magic. But at this point, you doesn't need the other part. You can create the GANs in another state, and you can start creating the matter state with your emotion. But you need to come from the matter to GANs to free plasma, you know. We need to make these steps.
Yeah, beautiful. Definitely, you know, we're being led on a pathway, and each step, as we've learned bit by bit, as frustrating as at times it's been, you know, you feel like you're redoing something. But I realize now that this is a pathway that we have to walk in the learning, you know, and it's getting us to a, you know, it's a wonderful journey, and I love to be part of it. And I'm learning bits without even realizing it, bit by bit. And I just love the way it's unfolding.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay.
You said.
Really appreciate your input. It's just an amazing story as it unfolds here. It's incredible. It's great fun to hear the steps you're going through.
Yeah, thank you, Rick. Yeah, sure.
Jackie, if I speak French, can I join the French crew? As long as, like, I'm French from Quebec, but I do speak it and read it and write it. So can anyone join that French?
Yeah, on the Thursday teaching at 7 Central European time, it's free. You can have no problem, and it will be a pleasure to accept you. And to this is will be really nice.
Oh,
and
wonderful.
for the private teaching, you need to be a student of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute.
Yeah, I'm still working on that. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
So very much. I'm so excited with what you're saying because it makes 100% sense. Thank you.
Okay, you're very welcome.
Hi, Libby. Let's see some stuff that you made. We haven't heard from you in a while.
I've been moving. I just moved into a very small space, but I had a great time cleaning out a pond with some CO2, CuO, a touch of silver, and a touch of zinc, and people around here going, oh, the pond's looking so much clearer. And the fish that were in there seem to be happier. And I don't have pictures, so I can't show pictures yet. But soon.
That's okay, we just love to hear your voice.
Okay, I'm glad to be back. It was a trick to try and get up at 2 o'clock for myself, so I got in a little late, but I'm so excited I made the effort because what Jackie has just shared is exactly what I'm doing in my little mini tubes, and I'm making little bottles for my friends of CO2 guns, waters, and just little vials, but I'm giving them away and telling them, just put a few drops in your drinking water, and I'm
keep one in your hip pocket.
Yeah, and those little necklaces that Rick was showing, that would be a perfect gift for people. You know, you just make one little CO2 bottle, one little, and maybe the percentages so that because people just, they don't realize how powerful this is. And why, my one friend poured a whole bottle of CuO Gans water into the same pond before she, and I'm thinking, oh my God, did she kill everything? But she didn't. So it's just a learning curve for all of us, and I'm just so grateful to be here. I don't want to take up too much time, but I'm here and I'm listening and very happy to be back.
Great to hear your voice. Thank you, Libby.
You're welcome.
Hi, excuse me, Rick. I just forget to say something.
Okay.
Sure. It's only the most important things. It's the way we are presenting that to the other people, you know, because I speak to you because you are really advanced on this technology, and it's why I'm going so clear and so direct into the process. But when we speak with new person and with new people into this technology, we really need to be clear and respect the other person and going by gradient, you know, and because it's some people into the field who are not in that stage of understanding, and they are making some stupid things, you know. That I see a picture on the Facebook page that a guy take a big box of 20 liters and he shows and say, this is the liquid plasma and I want to throw away this 20 liters into the river, you know. And he posts this on Facebook page from the French part, and it's making so bad reputation, and so because for the other person, it's totally unreal, you know, and it's like if we are polluting all the water, you know.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm.
So we need to be really careful on how we introduce people on this technology and on the liquid plasma, because we can, Mr. Cash take a long time to bring us into it. He want to be sure that we are enough mature to get access to this technology and don't making some stupid things, you know, because we need to understand a few drops, it's so powerful, it's so energized, that we need to have a lot of respect of that. And this is really important, and I just want to precise that.
Yes, good.
That's exactly
good point.
What I learned. Thank you so very much. Very true.
Yeah.
Does somebody want a testimonial on that?
Go for it, Mark.
Well, I can tell you my experience right now, and I'm really I'm willing to tell everybody, and I know it's we're almost done with the session tonight. And it's up to Rick. It's about it's a little bit of a long story, but I can tell you, and I'll attest to it, and I'll stand up, and I'll probably be judged for it, but I don't really care anymore at this point.
No, go for it, Mark. We'd love to hear your story, I think. Yep.
Okay. Well, Jackie should know, and everybody knows, when we first started out with this stuff, that we weren't really sure about the emotional thing that came along with it. No, we weren't instructed as to how emotional it would interact with us. Me, I'm a thinker. I think way too much about this stuff. When I first started a long time ago, I had to think about a long, and I just did way too much. I had a lot of energy in my room. I had 16 different dances. I dipped everything. I nanocoded everything 12 different times. I had a lot of stuff going on. But to make a long story short, and I'll tell maybe anybody and everybody that's looking at me can tell me, did I do the wrong thing? Did I do the right thing? Me personally, I feel now that I've evaluated it, where I live and where I'm at, and I live in Detroit, Michigan, and it's a very violent area. It's we have a lot of natural water. We have a large clean water whatever. So anyway, I worked on this project for a long time, as much as everybody else, and I got scared, and it made me want to stop. And everybody knows I stopped with it, and I had some realities that now that I've learned that there's other things in the world that can happen that you can't understand, that will happen, that'll make you do things that you don't understand. So here it is. So I had all this stuff, nano-coated wires, Gantz water. I had like 20 gallons of Gantz and Gantz water. I got so upset that I had to throw everything away. I threw 20 gallons, 5 gallon buckets, 4 5-gallon buckets of Gantz down my toilet into the waterways of Michigan now. So I'm thinking, oh my God, what did I do? This stuff is so powerful. It's in the pipesway now. It's in the waterway. It's in the sewer system. It's I put 20 gallons of Gantz in the water system of Michigan. And I'm hoping with my intention, now that I'm thinking about it, that it will heal everything that is the worst part of Michigan and Detroit, of the killing and the abuse that has gone on here for decades. I hope that my Gantz went out in the waterways and is constantly putting out a healing effect in the area that I live. And I didn't even realize this, that what I did could possibly be something that could be a giving positive energy in the water system. Because if you think, I put 20 gallons down the pipes in a metal pipes that people are constantly urinating, which is salt, and people are cleaning, which is bleach and caustic, that is going into the sewer system. And now the guy that's at the sewer plant is going like, hey, is that gold down there? I don't know. It could be. But all this stuff is now going through the system. And once it rinses out, they put it into the Great Lakes, which now goes down the river and is being absorbed into the water intake valves of the water that everybody drinks in Detroit. So hopefully, what I hope in my intention, and please let it be, that it'll bring calmness to the area in which I live. Does that make
It does make sense in the sense that where you live is right next door to the major trauma happening in Flint, Michigan, where the water supply is contaminated with lead, and the people are all totally freaked out in the area. Whether they have the lead or not, they're still freaked out because they don't know, and they don't know what the effects are, and people's skin are breaking out and all kinds of issues happening. And it turns out the authorities were irresponsible, and there is a lot of lead in the water supply. Perhaps what you did is helping to alleviate that in some way, because it turns out that, for example, copper oxide, the black stuff, definitely takes lead out of water. Within an hour, it can take 99% of the lead out of a bunch of water that you put it in. Same thing with the copper oxide GANS materials. The way I understand it is that it's a major decontaminant, essentially. But it's also, I mean, you can't just drink it down as well. That stuff's pretty powerful, so it's not something you want to do that. But
No.
yeah, it's a bit of a fine line because, like
I had
Jackie
to
was
sit here and think
mentioning.
about it for 3 weeks, thinking, did I do a bad thing? Am I a bad person? Did I do something that was
Well, the
with
thing is,
all my friends and neighbors?
the thing is now that they're starting to look at this thing that's happening. For example, with the zinc oxide, it's in everywhere in the environment, in the oceans, all over the place, essentially. And as are some other oxides that are used in both the pharmaceutical and especially in the cosmetic industry. And there's definite proof that zinc oxide has beneficial effects inside the body and so on, and on the skin. And it's definitely a healing, zinc is a very much a healing element that way. But on the other hand, what happens when this stuff gets as a nanomaterial, as a nano size in the environment? And only now they're starting to look at that and trying to figure out, is this a good thing, bad thing? And of course, they're looking at it as a bad thing. They don't think about it as, oh, isn't it great? We have all these nanomaterials in the environment. And so there is some, this is an issue, will be an issue for the future. It is an issue in the present now with all these companies. For example, they had to change the laws in Europe, and now they have more laws about nanomaterials, and they're trying to get all these companies under the umbrella of the nanomaterial institutes and this sort of thing, and essentially have control over the situation, which means their friends and their companies are the ones that get to produce the stuff, and the rest of us are might get kind of shut down from it or whatever. But it comes down to a couple of things, I guess. One is having the knowledge and responsibility to use it to, the best of our ability, and also the intention behind it. Like you're saying, if you even if you can reform your intention afterwards, and reform it as, may this be used for the benefit of all beings everywhere, and have that solid intention behind it. Maybe that's enough to, say, erase or dissolve some, any of the negative effects that might have possibly occurred
I'm in
in
trouble,
some
one way
possible
or
future.
the
Well, you just admitted it to the world as well, which it really gets you in trouble.
Absolutely.
So
They can come and get me now
you
because
either save the world or you messed it
get
up.
power to the positive, you know? It's
I
like
figured.
the way I see it is that people are going to take what they need from it, you know, and give out what they don't need. You know, it's give it a positive projection, you know, and give it your good intentions, and there's no problem from what, you know, my limited understanding.
Yep,
Yeah.
and if that understanding changes according to certain information you get, then you just make the change and carry on enthusiastically into the future, basically. So
That's what I'm doing. That's what I
that's,
chose to do.
yeah, that's, I think
I
that's
want
what
to.
it's all about. That's that attitude of, going forward and, you know, having enthusiasm for the process, regardless, basically. And that can get you into trouble, but hey, you get yourself out of trouble. Or, you know, yeah. What's trouble anyway?
But it doesn't matter, because if nobody ever tried, we'd never have any progress.
That's right. That's
and
right.
Mark, and Mark, you wouldn't be the first. I remember Mario said that when he had a cleaning woman come into his place and she washed his CO2 down the sink. And I know when we first started doing this, many of us weren't sure what we were doing, and we threw a lot of stuff down the sink and down the toilet. So I think it's a global effort by all of us in our quote-unquote ignorance. We've probably all done something fantastic without realizing it.
Yeah, some people.
Fluoride, you know, there's a whole issue with hormones that are in the water. You know, they can filter it, but they can't take out some of those nanoparticles. You know, there's a lot of wild stuff out there.
Yes, and it could be that the CO2 GANS and the other ones as well actually help to precipitate out and get rid of a lot of that stuff that would otherwise go into the ocean, go into the fish, and we end up eating it again, and so on and so forth. And it locks it into place, so it's no longer a hazard, basically. So, as has been shown with the radioactive materials and with all the heavy metals, they any metal that has a positive charge, like lead, Pb plus, and so on, it bonds right to that copper oxide molecule. It just gobbles it up, binds it in place, and bingo, it's not going anywhere. So yeah, I've seen some of the tests with just pure copper oxide scientific tests, and it is amazing. You can basically put it into water, and within minutes, it's up to 99%, and within a couple of hours, it's 99.98% of the lead is gone from the water, and includes other heavy metals as well. So,
well, yep. As you would say, Rick, are we throwing the baby out with the bathwater?
Yes, right. Yeah.
Can I just add something from Mr. Cash, who gave me a great advice, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because when I'm doing that in my lake and all this kind of space, I make it with the right intention to clean my space. Mm-hmm. And at the beginning, it was the great intention, and I doesn't regret anything. I know it will be for the benefit of all the creatures. But at one point, Mr. Cash said to me, "Hey, look, you need to understand this is not your decision. This is the humanity decision." And now, after we make the first step, we show to the people it's possible, it's damaged nobody. Now we need to, for example, if we go to see the government or the people who are responsible for all the mess, and we need to take the decision together, you know, and we need to learn to not force anything, but to give the collaboration with all our community. So it's why now I'm not doing anymore the cleaning of the lake, because I do my part, and now I need to start making the other understanding the process, and together we meet and we decided what we want, like Mr. Cash made in China, for example. Because he can go in China and make all the depollution and all the cleaning, but this is not the responsibility of the Cash Foundation or the Mr. Cash. It's the responsibility for the Chinese people who decided to take the situation and make the job, you know. And so you can be really peaceful. You do a great things for your country. It's beautiful what you are doing, you know. But now we need to go a step further and allow the other person to take the decision, you know. It's mm-hmm. and this right. is why I just before said it's the important things. It's the story that we tell and how we present things to the other person, and not to force anything, you know, to take the other with us, not against, you know. Mm-hmm. And it's why we need to learn how to present these kind of things.
Mm-hmm, true. Like, for example, I see a huge opportunity right now with this fire in northern Canada that's destroyed a good part of a city, and it's continuing to spread all over. And thousands of people, or approximately 100,000 people, have had to evacuate the area. And it's been 3 weeks now, and the whole area now is contaminated. On the air pollution scale of 1 to 10, it's at 38 right now. And it's so bad they've had to take the emergency workers out of the city that are trying to rebuild the city and hook things back up. They've had to get them out because the air pollution is so bad that they can't even work. Everyone wears respirators, but it's beyond that now, and they're recalling people and so on. I'm thinking, you know, there's so much toxic stuff happening here. There's ash all over the place. It's all from toxic things. But what an opportunity for a cheap, you know, not cheap, inexpensive way to treat contaminated areas. I mean, basically, they should be water bombing the area with CO2 GANS water, you know. Maybe that is a secret. Someone talked about gasoline didn't burn so well with the CO2 GANS in it, but it burned well with the copper oxide GANS. What if the water bombers that were bombing the fire had CO2 GANS in them, and it puts the fire out more effectively than the fire retardant that they're using now, which is totally toxic stuff. They're spraying it all over the place they're literally bombing the place with toxic fire retardants and all these toxic things that are burning, the oils and gases and so on and so forth. So, but I see it not as a disaster so much, because not that many people have actually died from this. Very few have died. It's all been organized quite well. But it's huge. It's going to be ongoing for weeks and weeks, if not months. It's the greatest disaster in Canadian history, and it's going to cost literally tens of billions of dollars to recover from, if it ever does. So, huge opportunity, I think, for Keshe Foundation, and I hope to get involved with that, those kinds of things with the Keshe Foundation Canada. And with the Keshe Foundation International as well. So, anyway, I think we should probably get things wrapped up here for today. Any other comments or questions that we can... Oh, Salma, you had your hand up there, and I think you had something I was supposed to show.
Yeah, Rick, I already sent you the photo in your Facebook and your Messenger. Did you get it?
Yeah, let me try to get that set up here again.
Thank you, Rick.
I think it was in... Just trying to find out where that was. Maybe it was in the Skype, was it?
No, Messenger and your Facebook.
Okay, let me check there. There we go.
Thank you, Reed.
Okay, let me get this set up here. And do the share. So this is what you're talking about, correct? Do you see that? Maybe it didn't come through yet. Try it again. Oh, wait a minute. I see what's happening. The window's too big. Let me make it smaller.
That just got smaller.
Yeah, I'm trying to make it smaller first because the window's too wide and it's going off the screen, and that causes issues with the share and all kinds of heck breaks loose when that happens. Okay.
Yeah.
So you see that?
My health unit is built in Indonesia.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It's just that my idea that health unit should not be showing too much coil. People might get frightened out of it.
Right.
So I fully cover it with acrylics.
Acrylic, but it's not clear. It's a tinted blue acrylic. Is that right?
No, that is just the LED lights.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm.
So it's the acrylic is dark brown and all the colors are coming from the LED.
I see.
I thought anybody coming in using this would be more at ease, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than all that, all my coil are inside, all the sink are inside.
So you have six coils on each side, or eight, or how what kind of configuration?
Yeah, six on each side on the top, mm-hmm. and on the left, I have 9. I'm supposed to have 12. I'm gonna get it fixed soon. You know,
the right six on. Is
the normal that everybody have.
Yeah,
it just reach to your shoulder. It doesn't go up. It go higher than that. It's more. It's more like shooting, you know, if you don't see the coils and all that.
Mm-hmm. And the colors are soothing too. It's a nice color.
Just that in Indonesia it comes cheap, so I thought why not, you know.
So yeah, it's very very beautiful, very very good looking. I'd love to put one in the doorway so everyone that comes into the house has to walk through it.
That is
that's correct. A good idea.
So, I have a therapy place to do the therapy. I call it a therapy because I don't have all the licenses. So it just I use all the field to cure people in Indonesia.
And you're having good results.
Beautiful result. Cancer, they stay so far away. But they come to the therapy room, and they sit on the therapy room, and they say the first time I get to sleep after so long, you can see the smile on their face.
Hmm.
Yeah, and now they're recommending all their friends to come.
Right on, nice.
Yeah, in the beginning, my friend standing there, he's helping me, so. When I first started, it's because of he was having lung TB, you know.
Mm-hmm.
He was losing weight and he couldn't find work. And now he's in good physical, what I call it, and healthy, you know.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
But what I want to say is about this health unit, yeah. I build it, but I can't use it on anybody.
because I'm not a doctor.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but I just believe, and maybe one of these days I'm the last man standing. I can use it. That's the only situation that I can use this health unit.
Right. Well, at least you have something for your friends and others that they can use it. It doesn't have to be paid professional use that way, right?
Yeah, but the thing is that I don't want to take risks with people, you know?
Right.
I can use the leg, but I cannot do the body, or I cannot do the head.
Mm-hmm.
I already have my helmet, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But I already have it, but I can't use it for the brain. I also find it is too complicated. It's so sophisticated that somebody who is really an expert or a medical practitioner should be doing it rather than we, the layman, you know.
Right, right.
Yeah, so
but yeah, it's a new area. It's a new area, and there's a lot to be learned with that.
Yeah, okay.
I did see a helmet that some scientists were using a few days ago in some post.
What I learned from what they did is like is something that you got to have full knowledge, and you don't go into it if you only a layman. But Ring, I just want to add, I'm very glad a lot of doctors and scientists is going into Keshi technology, you know. I'm very glad of that.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah, so it's okay. It's just a small step back for me where I wait for them to advance the technology. Then maybe I can step back in, you know, with the software or whatever they can come out with.
Here's
you saw the doctors and the scientists. I find them really like a genius.
Here's a helmet that the scientists are working with now, apparently.
All right.
This one actually measures the brain activity, like an EEG and so on. But wow. I thought it was amazing similarity. This just came out May 11th. That's last week. And if you look at our other, let me see if I come up with one of the helmet pictures. I've got one here. Let me see.
You're back to a little thin strip, Rick.
Oh, okay. This doesn't like my full screen. Can you, is it okay now?
Oh, there we go.
Wow, but this is Keshi, right?
No, this is from a medical, it's from Gizmag magazine. I'll give the, you can see the website at the top there. And it's basically an article about some scientists that are, it's got electrodes wired into it and so on, and it says within a minute of being put on the patient, then the helmet can begin taking readings. Software compares them to a database of readings taken from people known to have traumatic brain injuries to see if they're similar. This is in the ambulance, for example, and they basically take a reading of the brain in the ambulance on the way to the hospital. So it mentions, it's interesting, this last line I just read, a consortium is now working on refining and commercializing the technology. So this is becoming really, really big. I just want to get a picture of the Kesh technology, if I can find one here. There's
kind of flash of the doctor's offices in the future. You know, they put you into a helmet like this, and then they've had a whole lot of booths, like telephone booths, that you just go and stand in, and you know, walk out. Thank you very much.
You can see in this one, the Chinese with their helmet. That's there's at least half a dozen helmet designs right now, and you can also see.
Mr. Keshe, when you put on the helmet, you're not supposed to go more than 5 volts. So, you know, you got to be careful in all this. Yeah?
Yeah, I guess so. That's right. And here's another...
I think I'm having a step back at the moment. I'm waiting if the genius and the doctors and the scientists will come out with a software that I can buy, you know.
Mm-hmm.
They were helpful for we the layman. They've been learning Keshe in the background, I think. And what they learn from Keshe, it seems that it's just something they've been waiting for.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Here's a picture of another picture of another health helmet.
I don't dare to touch this at the moment. To tell you the truth, I don't take risks when I do any therapy. Or
yeah, it's fooling people's brains.
It's not my standard. Huh?
Yeah, it's a little beyond me.
I tell you, my personal view, Rick. My personal view, I find everything that Mr. Keshe said all are true. All true. For the health need, for what? The GANS, the pin pen, you know, for the ping pong reactor, it's all true. Reduction, all saving. I find all saving. I found out about all saving when I'm in Indonesia, you know. It's true. You can get about 30 to 50%.
Right on. Good. Getting a lot of reports like that nowadays, yeah.
Yeah, everything that he say is all true. Agriculture, I do it in my garden, you know. Oh, I find wonderful result. Yes. And you remember at one time, I also was a bit bedridden with back pain and muscle deficiency. I'm not strong at muscle where I can drop, you know. And now I'm having a wonderful health. All thank you to Mr. Keshe and his knowledge and all the knowledge seeker in the background, you know.
Right on. That's a good story. Thank you for sharing that.
Yeah. Okay, Rick, I'll leave you here.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to have to wrap it up here now. So, wow, great interchange. Special thanks to Jackie for donating his time here and letting people know about that technology. It's amazing. He's gone 2 months now on the liquid GANS, basically the liquid plasma, so incredible.
Just a quick add-in, Rick. Any idea how I can maybe look see into Philippines with Renan? Because it's about the same situation in Indonesia where I have to introduce.
Pardon me, you want to contact Renan in the Philippines?
How can I go to Philippines, whose permission I need and all that? Because the situation is the same. It's like Indonesia and Philippines is about the same with villagers.
Right.
So I need to show and tell in Indonesia so that I can hook up to a doctor, you know?
Right. Well, definitely you should contact Renan, probably with the innovation department.
Okay. Thank you, Rick. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, and thank you, everybody. Yes, indeed. Okay. Well, let's wrap it up then. great show. Thanks for all the stuff there. And yeah, that'll be it for what is now a Wednesday, May 18th, 2016. And for Keshe Plasma Reactor Group, I'm Rick Crammond, and see you again next week. All right, let's stop the live stream.